What's up, everybody? We have an apocalypse of new music this week. Instead of like skipping over a big chunk of them, what I'm gonna do is literally cover all 50 songs, drops only. It's gonna be pretty bang bang. Let me know if you guys like this or if it's too quick. I'm just trying something new, but let's jump into it. So if you like the intro song, for those of you who aren't super familiar, Mashbit, up-and-coming artist, actually remixed the intro for us. Just dropped his latest EP. We're going to cover one of those songs. Check it out. Nice. Beautiful. Ooh. Switching it up, okay. Yeah, it's a refreshing take on like the whole melodic bass theme. Oh, kind of like this. Especially for Armin. That's catchy. I mean, the vocal's a little gimmicky, but I like it. Yeah, it doesn't have it. That's not it. What? What? Oh, I saw this at EDC Orlando. Shit. Yeah, this is cool. I was just saying, this sounds vaguely familiar. Pretty minimal, kind of, you know, experimental. That's kind of their vibe. Nice. Yeah. Feels a tad bit slow, but other than that, I'm not complaining. Ooh. Oh! Yes. Oh, so much better in the second half. Love the creativity rhythmically. Ooh. Yeah, real smooth. Nice tech house feel. Real familiar sound. Groovy bass line, but not super creative. We got some BT. Super talented producer, been in the game for a long, long time. This feels more like a down-tempo kind of ambient vibe. Yeah. Nice atmosphere on it. Creative with the lyrics. Yeah, real deep bass line. Catchy. Not sure if it's gonna stick around, but yeah, there's gonna be a lot of genres in this video. Where's the hardstyle fans? It's growing on me, but you really gotta be in a different setting for it. Like, you just don't listen to this by yourself. Maybe you do, I don't know. I like the attention to detail, the percussion. Pretty mellow. That's kind of the whole Bidberg vibe. Except Roman Silver, he's like the outlier, but not bad. Four on the floor, all right. Really full sound, well done. Vocals nailed it too. This is one of those I need more time with, but we gotta stick to the schedule. Okay, if I'm gonna get on the Slap House train, this isn't awful, but that's all Spinnin wants to put out these days. Catchy melodies over that over plucky bass line. All right, any Frankie Wah fans are gonna be upset because you obviously need a whole song to enjoy this, but I'm gonna try to pick out a good 10-second segment. Love the harp running in the background. More impressive stuff from him. Yes. This is a vibe. I like how like the pre-drop was kind of just like a subtle release. Yeah. Not bad. I'm not super familiar with Friendzone. I've seen the name before, but something gives me like Foo Fighters vibes about this whole chord progression. Go back to like the intro and listen to it. Nice. Yeah, this makes sense why Gravitz and Rez did that collab track, because they really do have like a weird like intersection of sound at times. Yeah, I'm adding this one. He's got such a unique balance of like that indie rock and electronic. All right, I'd be an idiot if I didn't basically cover the whole song, so we're gonna have an exception for this one. Damn! The first half of that first drop, I was like, it feels like they're holding back a bit. Oh! Love that. Like that continuous, gritty, I don't even know what to call that. Ooh! Oh! The triplets! Ooh! Oh, I'm so glad I caught this third drop. It's definitely the best one so far. For a song that's basically a sequel to already, you know, something that's an absolute classic, that was pretty good. Breaking the remix rule because if found, if somebody's gonna spice up a Griffin track, it's probably them. Ooh, didn't expect a... I thought we were going more for like a rhythm kick clap feel. Damn! Filthy! Manu, fresh off that suggestion video, shout out to any of you that threw that name down there. A big fan. Oh. Wow. I love like the sound design, whatever he layered in there. It just sounds fresh. Yeah, his sound just feels like it's on the future horizon of wherever electronic music is going. Ooh! Oh, he nailed it! He nailed it! Or they nailed it, I'm sorry. I forgot she's on the vocals and a producer. But you know that's Kayvon sound. I'm such a sucker for that old school future bass sound. It's not really old school, but you know. Some people would tell me Kay Tronada's not really under like the electronic genre, you know, more like a R&B producer, but I'm such a big fan, so we're covering it. There's some patented snap claps. Something about his music just really resonates with me. Just always some of the really well-crafted effects, sound selections. Ooh. Drop bill like it lacks some punch. Whatever happened in the build, it just kind of felt like we just... We'll listen to drop two. Because I know it's about to get violent. A little chaotic for me. Like, it doesn't sound as crisp and clean as it could be, but yeah, I don't know. Ooh! Is that reggaeton style beat? Nice! Well, we've got Jana. Be sure to check out her latest album. She just dropped that. Nice. She's got like a nice easygoing feel. Leaves her a lot of room for the vocals to breathe. Kind of like how erratic it is. I don't know if it's the art, but it feels a little bit quicker than typical. Pushing like the 176, 180 range, maybe? Nice. Feels like a little bit of a throwback to their old sound. Kind of want a little more out of this drop, though. Yeah, some oscillating saw waves in here, maybe. It's not bad. It's a vibe. It just leaves me wanting a little more. There was like a billion comments about this one, so I'm gonna spend a little more time on it. Everybody's saying it's his best song yet, so high praise. Definitely Nurko. You guys hype this up too much, though. I don't know if it's his best song. I like the bridge here. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I need to listen to that a little more. I think I had a little bit too high expectations. It's good. I like how it's kind of more of an uplifting. Not his best, in my opinion, but it's up there. Oh! Wait a minute. I almost cut it short. I'm glad I stayed for the last bit of this. Noron Pure. More of the same, but no complaints. Just a journey through a melodic, old school kind of progressive house feel. I saw Carbonara and I was like, why would they name a song like this? And then I saw Spag Heddy, so it makes sense. Not my favorite Pixel Terror work. Wait. Ooh, I like what they did with the chords. Ooh! Wait a minute. Okay, just kidding. I don't know. I have mixed feelings about all this. Plugo with his first release in a long time. Using his voice a lot more. Who knew? Plugo can sing. I mean, we kind of knew that from his Colorblind album, but... Oh, it was so hype to see him at EDCO. This is nice. He didn't play this either. Trap music. Let's go. Oh man. Yeah, this dude's got talent. That's gonna be up there. That's a good one. All right, we're gonna be doing a Rez album review on the channel, but I had to peep this one real quick. This is a single because it's a Peekaboo collab. Real grimy. Thought it would go a little heavier. Granted, I'm only like previewing a little bit of it. I think this one just caught my ear. Ooh, yeah. This is only for the main stage. And lasers are a must. Shaloo, a little down-tempo detox here. Yeah, this is a definite ad for me, throwing this on the down-tempo. Okay, I thought we were still building. Ooh, wow. I like what they did. Is that a saxophone or a vocal swell? It's pleasant. I hate being that guy that says you miss the old version of an artist, but I kind of do. Oh, I love his style. Nice. Love what he did with the snare. Do not sleep on Tenebrax. Tristan with a... definitely a different vibe from him. Like this shaker he's got going on in the background, whatever that is. It's super chill. I'm surprised to see that from him, honestly. I know he's been doing a lot of different stuff lately. This is different. Ooh. Nice. Kind of got like a... jungle feel? Am I wrong in saying that? Getting away from the bass house, this is real nice. I think it's just the percussion that makes me say that. Love the pan flute though. All right, I guess If Found gets two this week because they got a collab with We Are Fury. I wanted to check this out. Drum and bass! Surprise! Nice. What, like a little more volume out of the growls? They feel a little timid. Oh! Damn, that's a good one too. So well done. They're fighting to shine through a bit, but I like the sound. I swear to God, if this isn't a trap anthem, Yellow Claw. You can't title a song Trap Anthem and not have it be an absolute slapper. Like, it's okay. We got a new love anthem. It's in lane 8. This is also one of those songs that needs like 4 minutes of coverage, but what are you gonna do? Nice. Yeah. I love all of the sounds in this. Just spot on sound selection, sound design. Ooh! Holy shit! Wow, saving one of the best for last. This is insane. People have been telling me I need to check him out, so... damn.
This is the song of the week.
Thanks so much for watching. I hope that wasn't too quick in between songs. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Let me know what you thought song of the week should have been. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you soon.